Hello, Warralily Facebook and LinkedIn friends. It's Ben from Warralily. I've got Sammy Britton from Armstrong Real Estate and Megan Rovers from Armstrong Real Estate. So we're here to have a bit of a quick chat before our upcoming investment seminar, which is the 13th of June at our co-sales office at 6 p.m. Megan, Sammy, how are you going?
Good.
Excellent. Now, Sammy, I know you're a bit nervous, as I am. So we'll have a bit of fun. Firstly, before we start, Megan, Armstrong Real Estate is a new business.
Correct.
Newer business.
Mm-hmm.
Can you give the viewers a bit of an insight in regards to how it came about and how you as a person that's just moved down from Shepparton was studying law? you've moved out of area, fair way away. How it came about that you'd be a director and owner-operator of a real estate company?
Yeah, absolutely. So Armstrong Real Estate, I guess, is born out of the realisation of the whole Armstrong Creek growth corridor. So as Ben said, I moved down to study uni and my parents actually purchased an investment property in Armstrong Creek. So that's how it all started. I was living on res at Warm Ponds and studying at both campuses, Warm Ponds and Waterfront. We basically decided this was a great place to invest. Moved out here. We went through a local builder and I got a part-time job with that building company. And then from there, we thought, you know, we're selling to lots of investors and there's plenty of, you know, growth in the area. So I guess why not start a real estate agency up?
So you obviously clearly saw a niche.
Yeah.
And a bit of a gap in the market, given it's a new area that was growing quite significantly.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's obviously unique to Geelong and unique to, I guess, Victoria being, yep, you know, one of the biggest growth suburbs there is. So we thought, you know, it needed a fresh approach to, yep, real estate. So nothing that another real estate agency could offer. Yep. So all our systems were new, everything, all our processes were brand new. We didn't, yep, you know, copy anything or, yep, get ideas. We got ideas from other offices, but obviously thought, you know, what, as a new age real estate agency, how can we set ourselves, yep, apart in the market?
Yep.
So it was a great opportunity to obviously start off. We started off essentially selling from my lounge room. Yep. So Josh, our very first sales agent, used to dress up in a suit and then come see my home theatre, which he still reminds me of, yep, every day. But yeah, he's still here, which is great. Now there's 10 staff and we've got, you know, nearly 300 rentals, yep, as well. So it's grown a heap with the area. We're the only real estate agency with an office in Armstrong, yep, Creek in Warralily, which is fantastic.
Which we're sitting in the new village your nice new digs.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, you can't see any of it.
We'll turn the camera around so you can see the scene. Yeah. It's very impressive.
Yeah, so it's great. Obviously, we always said we had our finger on the pulse, given that majority of our agents actually live in Armstrong Creek and in Warralily. Yep. So we always are around the area, always believed in the area, invested in the area. Yep. But now we're literally... don't leave. We work here, live here. We don't really leave the area very often.
Obviously a healthy work-life,
yes,
balance.
Yes, absolutely. Exactly. Absolutely. Yeah.
So speaking of rentals, obviously you said you had a substantial rent roll.
Mm.
So Sammy,
mm-hmm,
so you're the rental manager.
I am.
And obviously a disclaimer, Armstrong Real Estate do look after my rental property and very impressed. But Sammy, do you want to just give us a bit of an insight? You mentioned you had a really busy month this month.
Yes.
So 18 properties.
We listed 19 properties in the month of April.
Yeah.
Yes. 19, and I believe Madison, our leasing manager, leased around 12 to 14 properties.
Yep.
So really good month, really busy month. So a lot of those new listing properties will be coming up,
yep,
in May,
yep,
obviously being completed by the builders. So a lot will be happening in the area, which is really good because even though our properties are growing, our portfolio is growing, we're still having a really good marketing. Our average marketing days is,
yep,
decreasing. So I believe our lowest was March, and it was 7.5 days,
yep,
on market. And last month being April was 8.6 days. So,
which I know as a landlord, or was a potential landlord, that was probably my major concern, dipping my toe into the rental market was, what if my property's built and then you can't find a tenant? So I know with my property, obviously you endeavoured, because you had some similar properties that were on the market at the time, to try and, if they weren't suitable or that property was tenanted, to shift them across,
mm-hmm,
without me obviously spending any advertising.
Correct.
Which was obviously beneficial if we could do it, because then we'd save on the advertising dollars. Obviously, we weren't able to do that, but the minute you put the board up, I think it was leased within, less than 7 days.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. So we do that quite often. So if a property doesn't suit a current tenant that we've got advertised, if we know properties that are coming up and we've listed them available for rent coming up in the future from the builders, we can just go straight to that database and hopefully, you know, transfer the tenants to those potential tenant properties coming up and have that lease before they even have handover from the builders even.
Because would that be, and it seems to be, you guys have obviously got market share, but would that be one of your points of difference, the fact that you do specifically work more from a sort of a prospect point of view with regards to you gather a list of potential tenants and then you match them to the property?
Definitely. I think that's our aim at the moment with so many new properties coming up. A lot of properties, you know, we see other agencies struggle to find tenants, whereas being a local agent in the area, a lot of potential tenants come directly to us.
Yep.
And luckily for us, we do have a leasing manager who deals with those potential tenants and pretty much looks after them from day dot and wants to secure them a property.
Because tenants obviously should get the same level of service that, say, a prospective purchaser should get as well.
Mm, yeah. Absolutely, yeah. So having that database is exactly what you mentioned, Ben, is being able to say, okay, we found a great tenant and look, most tenants are pretty good at applying in Armstrong Creek. Let's not let them just try and find a property themselves.
Yep.
That is the easiest way. Lease out a property, chuck it on realestate.com. Look, anyone can do that.
But
if we find a great tenant, they've got a great application, they miss out on one house, why not put them in another landlord's house? So as Sammy said, we can get an estimate, okay, well, that's what, 2 weeks until it's finished construction.
Yep.
These people need a house in three. Yep. Let's put them in this one. Yep. Away we go. So it means that landlords obviously are less out of pocket for, you know, between getting the keys and tenants moving in.
So it's obviously not all about exposing your business, it's trying to get the most efficient, cost-effective solution to the landlords.
Absolutely.
So we don't want to obviously give too much away with regards to the rental and sales presentation that Armstrong Real Estate will carry out at our investment seminar on the 13th. But just from a growth point of view, Megan, obviously the last 12 months has been pretty crazy. You obviously be pretty happy with how quickly houses are selling, but also the prices that are being achieved.
Yeah, absolutely. So this time 12 months ago, we thought we were in a great market, given that when we first started selling, average days of market, we were probably nearly 180 plus for sales. Now, sometimes it's like we've been on the market for 180 hours and it's sold. So definitely a few things have, I guess, helped the sale market, and that is all the great infrastructure that we've got here now. So the shopping centre, the new school, the retirement village that's under construction, childcare, you know, we can keep going on and on. But it just means that more people know about the area and have absolute confidence, because there is so much more planned and there's still so much more happening. So investors and owner occupiers can, you know, invest their money in with absolute confidence that it is going to take place. So the market in December, we had a peak, given that the shopping centre had opened and the school was opening this year. And then March again, we've just had a huge peak in the market as well. So the median house price is just over $500,000, which is fantastic. And I always say we're sitting in a really unique spot here, given that we've got two great markets and we're, you know, I guess bookending us, the Torquay market and the Geelong market absolutely booming. So absolutely. It's
with
really
lots of stuff still to be built. So we might close on that note. Was there anything else, Sammy, Megan, that you wanted to add before we finish up?
Yeah, I guess if you are thinking of investing in Armstrong Creek, we're still rolling.
if something came up, that was the low battery sign, so
if you are thinking of investing in Armstrong Creek, we would definitely recommend just to have a chat to us, or obviously come along to the investment seminar. There are certain tricks and tips that you can have to either, you know, get the maximum value out of the capital growth of your property, or to get maximum rental yield in terms of what to build and what to include and everything. So absolutely have a chat to us. We won't force you into anything.
And it's not that I'm a midget, it's just the way the angle is of the camera. So guys, thanks once again. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks, Harry.